What's up, ladies and gentlemen? We are playing Wild Rift Warplanes. I played Wild Rift Warplanes the other day. This is my first game. Didn't actually...
Show me what you can do, pilot! Let's roll!
So I didn't do the tutorial, so I have no clue what to do. So, here's hopefully the first one.
Is concentrating forces near the airfield.
do. Seems to me like pretty near impossible to shake someone off your head once they're on. So your best hope is to sort of come in behind you.
Receiving reports about rapidly deteriorating weather conditions. Support will be unable to reach you. Do you read me? Over.
Yeah, that was pretty good. I mean, I'm going to turn it in here, but I can definitely be doing it first. So it's interesting to note that these are mostly interrupter gear style plants, which means I can't see my mouse. But you see the problem in front of the plane there.
There's no way to break through to you now.
And
you're on your own.
What that means is my machine gun is most likely silent through it. So, one thing I would be having then would be an interrupter gear. An interrupter gear is, I believe, an original German during the First World War. But what it did is it allowed their machine guns to pause in firing so the propellers might be coped in the past, which was a very important development because originally you only had machine guns to be pausing. So your pilot also served as your gunner, except he was trying to fire a Lewis gun or something. Thank you.
initiative. I'm proud of you, pilot. Head back home.
So, yeah, that was my first game. So, I think that went well. I think I should have done the tutorial. But, see how we did. So, go away. So we got 9,000 experience. And 16,000 credits. I guess we got 3,000 experience, or that might be free experience. So it looks like I shot down 8 aircraft. Yeah. I think we did that. So I guess we just sort of look around and things, I guess. Yeah, so I guess I got 3,000 XP, not 9,000. Now I'm going to let's go ahead and max this out. Engine. Purchase mount. Ooh, don't have audio bar. I'm gonna move my stream bar or my recording bar. Let's get some rockets. We all love rockets. So I guess you only need one battle to max out this plane. It's fun. So let's go see what this does. Waiting in queue is probably going to take a while. It took me about a minute 20. First time. Reminds me a lot of the Blazing Angels 2. Is it the first one? It might be the second one. But that's another one of the games where you're, you know, playing an aircraft and going around trying to shoot things out of the sky. And one of my favorite maps in that one, though, is full of icebergs. And you're going down and you're going in and you can weave out in amongst the aircraft.
Cover your allies! Hit the enemy! And we shall win!
So what I like to do is I like to take the fastest plane that's a German rocket plane and just sort of weave in amongst their near full speed to block other planes crash. No one can get a good shot at that. Kind of fun. But that one's a lot more. That map specifically, during that game, you go around and it's like you and one other person. Usually we just do it as my dad and I. And so we go shoot, get up, sink the enemy ships, and destroy the enemy tanks and enemy guns, destroy the fuel depots, command positions, stuff like that. Pretty fun. I don't need water. Well, I say I'm pregnant. I want to loop all the way around. But I'll probably just poke around. And it sort of depends on where everyone else goes. So far, I've had my first few times, most times, of any of the games. I mean, the best rating on, you know, on 0 to 10, out of 10, I did well before 6 and 8, well, I think, with 7.3, this is probably going to get a 6.2. It is just not doing well. Oh look, maybe we'll actually get to play the game. Nope, battle queue ended. I'm going to call it here. This is just a piece of shit. I hope y'all have a good day.